Now we have to move on to the much more interesting higher order equations using fourth order Runge-Kutta. As with the Euler, let me remind you, and again I'm doing this right here using my Python shell. Well, actually this is not the shell. I said file, a new file, and this is the file I'm working on. So here we go. We have y double prime as some function containing x, y, and y prime. We see it there. Remember, I put these little hashtags there. That would be shift 3 on the keyboard, just to tell Python that this is a comment, a human comment, and Python will just ignore in that line whatever comes after this hashtag. So if I just look at my example down here, I have y double prime plus x y prime plus y equals 0, and it's an initial value problem. Note that though there's a y double prime in there and a y prime. So if I just, simple algebra, bring these two to the other side of the equation sign, we're going to have y double prime, that is our function there, y double prime, it's a function of x, y, and y prime, and lo and behold, there's an x there, a y, and a y prime. That's what we mean by second order. We're going to solve this, creating two first order equations by bringing in this new function u and letting it being equal to y prime, such that y double prime now becomes u prime, and that is now a function of x, y, and u. Remember, u being y prime. So it's just that u equals y prime now. We're also going to remember that we're just going to increment our x. And let me just remember that, and this is Euler, remember, for Euler. But just to remember that I want to move along the x-axis and I want to move along the y-axis. And this is how it's going to work. Because I now have two first order equations, I have y prime and u prime, I have to now get a function for y and a function for u. And I'm going to do it by stepping along a certain step size. And y of n plus 1 is going to be y sub n plus a weighted average. And it's going to be h divided by 6 of these values, m sub 1, m sub 2, m sub 3, m sub 4, such that I have this twice m sub 2 and twice m sub 3 there, makes it a weighted average, and I have to divide by 6. And I must not forget that I also have u sub n plus 1 now, which equals u sub n plus, again, h divided by 6 times this weight, so divided by 6 of this k sub 1 times twice k sub 2, twice k sub 3, and k sub 4, again a weighted average. Now, with that information, I've got to tell you what m sub 1 until m sub 4 and k sub 1 through k sub 4 is. It is such that these two equations are such that m sub 1 equals u sub n, m sub 2 is u sub n, so the previous u, plus h over 2 times k sub 1. So in order for me to move on to m sub 2, I need to know what k sub 1 is, so I have to jump all the way to k sub 1, and k sub 1 tells me it is just a function of x sub n, y sub n, and u sub n. In other words, it is this new function that I created that contains u. So I need that before I can do m sub 2. To do m sub 3, I have to know k sub 2. There's k sub 2. To do k sub 2, I need to know m sub 1, fortunately, which I already have, which is up there. So you can very clearly see, it's easy to memorize these, what m sub 1, m sub 2, m sub 3, m sub 4 is. This is u sub n all the time plus h over 2 times k sub 1, h over 2, k sub 2, h k sub 3. And to remember what the k sub 1 through k sub 4 should be. You can just memorize it there. But what you very clearly note is that you can't do all the m's in Siri and then do all the k's, because m sub 2 depends on the value of k sub 1. So you'll have to do m sub 1, then k sub 1, then m2, then... but to do m2, you need k1, so then do k1. Then you do m3, but for m3, you need k2, so you do k sub 2. Then you go to m sub 4, but for m sub 4, you need k sub 3. So therefore, you do k sub 3, so you'll have to go back and forth. Another thing you have to note is, say, let's look at k sub 2. K sub 2, there's a certain you're going to use this function f, the f of x sub n, y sub n, and u sub n. But you need very specific values of x, and it's going to be the previous x plus half times the step size. For y, you're going to have the previous y plus half times the step size times m1. And for u sub n, for u to plug that into k sub 2, you're going to need u sub n plus h over 2 times k sub 1. Just very quickly look at that. U sub n plus h over 2 times k sub 1. Where have we seen that before? Well, that's nothing other than way up here. That's m sub 2. So I can actually just make life easier for myself. Let's put in m sub 2. And I'm denoting sub by these little square brackets. Look at k sub 3. It's going to, you're going to use your new function, your f of x, y, and u. And inside of that, you're going to have this value for x. So you have to do that first. You have to get a value for x, this value. You have to get this value for y. And you have to get this value for u. But again, where did we see this before? Oh, look at that. That seems to be, to me, to be nothing other than... Where would that be? That seems to be nothing other than u sub n plus... There we go, u sub n plus h over 2 k sub 2, that's m sub 3. So I can just rewrite this as m sub 3. Just making my life easier, I don't have to recalculate those things. So just think about doing k sub 1, it's very easy because you're just going to the function that you were given, the example problem, just plug in x sub 0, y sub 0, u sub 0. And u sub 0 is y prime sub 0, remember. Then to get k2, you'll have to first have this, get this value, and you'll have to call it something other than x. In my instance, I call it x sub 2 and calculate that first, then calculate y sub 2, and then calculate u sub 2, but we don't need u sub 2, it's just m sub 2 as before. Now you have those values, and now you have to plug it into my f of x sub n, y sub n, u sub n, and then get that. Let's make life a bit easier through an example. So we have y double prime plus xy prime plus y equals 0, and this initial value problem, in as much as if x is 0, y is 2, and if x is 0, y prime or u is 2. First of all, create two equations. First one was always going to be u equals y prime. That makes, so what do you have to do? You have to get y double prime on its own. So I'm taking these to the other side. This is now a function of x, y, and y prime. But remember, y prime is nothing other than u, and u prime is nothing other than y double prime. So these two are equal. That's negative x times u, which is y prime, minus u. So to do this is really easy. Now I'm starting to write code. My x value initially is 0. When x is 0, y is 2 and u is 2. I put the point 0 because I want floating point operations here. I don't want integers. So u is nothing other than, remember, y prime. And my step size is 0.05. Remember, this backslash n just means a carriage return, hitting enter for a new line, and I'm doing that 40 times. That's just something to clean up the shell. Then I want to print x and y as two integers. I've put it in these quotation marks, double quotation marks. I could also have used single quotation marks, but then I have to use single quotation marks throughout. Then I want it to print the value of x and y. At the moment, x is 0 and y is 2. Now we want to run through a while loop. And you have to keep it together here. We're going to run through it until x is less than 0.25. Remember, we're starting x at 0. So while this is happening, I put it in little parentheses. And after that, I put a colon, which means all of this underneath will be indented. That means this forms part of a loop and will continue going into the loop and up until x reaches 0.25, and then it will exit the loop. So what is my first I need to get M1. There we go, I have to get M1, and I see M1 is this U sub N. So M1 is just U what it is at the moment. U at the moment is 2. To get K sub 1, remember what K sub 1 was, it's just a function of X sub 0, Y sub 0, U sub 0. Which is here, there it is, negative X times U minus Y. That's what it is, so it's negative X times U minus Y. The K1 version of this function. Now we'll do M sub 2. We've done M sub 1, K sub 1, now we move on to M sub 2. M sub 2 is still relatively easy. It's this U sub N, which is the U that we have at the moment, plus a half times the step size times K sub 1. We've just done K sub 1. Now though, we see we can't just do K sub 2. Before we do K sub 2 here, we have to develop values for X, for Y, and for U, and we're fortunately we've seen U is very easy to get. We've already done U. But I have to call them something new. So I'm just calling them X underscore 2. It's a new variable, and it's going to be X plus half of the step size. Y underscore 2 as Y plus half of the step size times M1. The M1 that we've just done, and U sub 2 we know now is M sub 2. Now I can do K sub 2. And in the place of X, I put this new variable that I've just gotten, X underscore 2. Instead of U, I put in U underscore 2. And instead of Y, I put Y underscore 2. It's Y underscore 2, you can name it whatever you want, as long as you don't name it X, Y, and Z, because it's not X, Y, and Z you want to plug into this equation here. You want to plug in these variables that you had to calculate before you put them into the function f. And the same is going to happen to K3. First of all, you have to develop X sub 3, Y sub 3, and U sub 3. Then you can plug it into the f of X, Y, and U. And same goes for X sub 4, Y sub 4, oh, X underscore 4, Y underscore 4, U underscore 4, before you plug it into the f of X, Y, and U. And there you go. Now at the end of the loop, I want X sub n plus 1. So what does the computer code do? What is X at the moment? It's 0. What is the step size? 0.1. So the new X value before we go into the loop now is going to be 0.01. Is it less than 0.25? Yes, it is. So we can run straight through again with the newest value of X and the newest value of Y and the newest value of U. And what is Y? Well, it's HY, the old Y, which came into this loop. I didn't use Y anywhere in this loop, so it's still outside here as 2, plus H over 6 times M1, twice M2, twice M3, and M4. And I need U right in the beginning, so I need to bring a new U in there. So there's my U, H over 6, K1, twice K2, twice K3, and K4. I want to print the new values of X and Y. They now go into the loop as the old X and Y, so that I can do X sub n plus 1 and Y sub n plus 1 using the old values that now enter the loop again. So let's say file, save, and all we're going to do now is we're just going to say run the module. We get a few blank lines and there we go. Y of 0, when X is 0, Y is 2, we know that. When it's 0.05, it's 2.097. When it's X is 0.1, it's 2.18, 0.15, 0.2. And we see exactly where these values go, plotting for X and Y, X and Y, X and Y, X and Y. So that's beautiful. Now, remember to exit. All I'm going to write is exit and open close parentheses. That's going to say this program is still running. Do you want to kill it? Okay. And we're back so that we can edit. So you can plug in any second order ordinary differential equation here as it stands with these constant coefficients. And what we can do, all you have to do is just to change these k sub 1, k sub 2, k sub 3, and k sub 4. You just have to change those equations to whatever the problem was. Remember, our problem was y double prime plus xy prime plus y equals 0 with the initial values. You just have to convert it to this so that this is what you plug into k sub 1, k sub 2, k sub 3, k sub 4, remembering that k sub 2, k sub 3, k sub 4 requires their own unique x, y, and u values.